Now, I don't really subscribe to cancel culture because typically people will lose a bunch of respect and followers for a while, but then eventually, like a bad wart, they will come back and continue to thrive. I will say over the weekend, I was thinking about how maybe like Pro Jared or this James Charles guy or all these other people who were canceled will make their revival. When one particular person jumped out to me, that is the face of, if you remember it, Bully Hunters, the fake cyberbullying disaster that was just a few years ago. Maybe, was it last year? It was a hilarious meme fest, including fake gameplay, fake cyber bullies, and fake Bully Hunters. It was a beautiful thing to watch fall apart. And that was headed up, of course, by Zombie Unicorn. And then Zombie Unicorn apparently still has connections. See, I think it's truly a sad thing in this world when you look at some of the creators, the kind of OG creators, who still have a lot of the connections, quote unquote, with people at like E3, but really nobody watches their content. It's one of the primary reasons I don't care at all about going to conventions because those personal relationships in the long term, are generally worthless. Yes, a bunch of people know who this person is, or you can apply this to other content creators. Yes, everyone knows them, but when you go and you view their streams or their YouTube videos, they get hardly any views. Why do you think that that is? All they have is their selfies that they take with people at E3 who will throw them aside the minute they're no longer useful to them. I saw a tweet by Zombie Unicorn. And by the way, I should say, please do not contact this person. This will be my last kind of tweet or comment on the subject. This is a iffy territory because I want to take a look at the ideas and some of the things that were said, but I don't want to get personal, and I don't want anyone to send any more bad vibes this person's way. They lost. They just lost badly. And I think when you win, and then you continue with the rubbins, you look bad. So this is to catalog the cancellation of Zombie Unicorn, and the hilarity that followed. But then that will be it because this person, when you have 100,000 followers on Twitter and you can barely muster 2 or 3 likes on videos after 8 hours, it's pretty clear that the world has forgotten you. But I do want to explore the idea, which started with a Instagram video, what appeared to be shaming some dancers at E3. Let's take a look.
Two companies at E3. It's 2019. Boob babes are nothing anymore. We don't do boob babes. Sexually objectifying women in ways that we don't need to be doing. So don't do it. Okay, cool. Thanks.
Now, this video, of course, sent off a wave of backlash. Some of the most, I will say, probably my most popular tweet, maybe in history, pointing out the fact that this particular, I don't know what you would call them, content influencer, I don't know, that this particular person hosts several streams, 18 plus streams on Twitch, where they put pasties on their chest and paint their body for what can only be described as 12-year-old boys with their mom's credit cards. I don't understand it. I have been on record as saying I think that that stuff doesn't belong on Twitch, that it's really, 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 really creepy. And I think anybody who denies the fact that little boys are back, with the lights turned down low, watching that is absurd. Nobody's watching that for the art, okay? And while there are people out there who are very good at it, I think that belongs on one of the hubs or some of these other sites where that can be facilitated to people who at least should be over the age of 18, except there's really no filters for that either, am I right? Anyway, and it was the unending hypocrisy of that statement. I think if it had been, your run-of-the-mill like feminist saying that, I would have laughed at it, but it wouldn't have been such a viral self-own because everybody knows what this person is about on Twitch, and they're not a gamer. They're about selling their body, in my opinion, for sponsorships. Now, the energy drink in question was Bang Energy Drink. Not really familiar with them until then, but I've reached out to Bang and let them know that I'm happy to promote their product should they write the right check. But, you know, I thought it was pretty interesting. And after some initial backlash, Zombie Unicorn had to back it up, but it was too late. The toothpaste was out of the tube, and once it's out, you can't put it back in.
I don't have a lot of time to respond, but I wanted to say the problem is not with the models accepting the gig. That's their choice. The problem is the company hiring women to purely be sexual objects and representing women as sexual objects in the gaming space. That's not okay.
Ah, truly ironic this is. Painting your body while fully nude for tips on Twitch from 12-year-olds, yet shaming female performers at a convention you are. Jealousy and envy. The path to the dark side. It is.
You know, again, I will point to the fact that this is a person that is in the gaming space that promotes her body to young boys for tips and Twitch subscribers. And to say the backlash was swift and complete would be accurate. As you can look, if we go, I mean, basically after, by the way, this is coming from a person who this was their pinned tweet. Now, I'm not making any comments about their physical appearance. I'm saying when this is your pinned tweet, don't talk to me about, you know, objectification. All right. But if you go back and when it started, these are all the responses of damage control. I'm not going to count them, but this is all responses to people saying, easy, wait a minute here. And as I scroll through this is all her trying to justify her position to her own followers. All right. So on top of everything, you know, these people who take these jobs, okay, these are aspiring models, aspiring actresses. It's still going. This is all her doing damage control. All of it. Keeps linking the same article about how PAX banned it and trying to use that as some sort of justification. Look, just because somebody else makes a mistake and you make the same mistake doesn't mean you're right. It just means you're both wrong. And these people who get these jobs, look, everybody knows to deal with booth babes. And here's the important thing that Zombie Unicorn decides to ignore. They do too. They know what the deal they're getting into. But as they try to get their acting jobs, or as they try to get their modeling jobs, or they try to get their promotional jobs, they've got to pay the rent. So these promotional type deals are how they do that. Now, Zombie Unicorn sees no problem with that doing it on Twitch. Of course, this is still going, by the way. This is all yesterday. All trying to reply, okay, and then today we've put up some more bait for people. Again, don't take the bait. This is somebody who also has some issue with negative attention. You know, this is somebody who continues to attack people personally for their bad take. You can see yesterday saying, keep going, incels. You haven't hit the ratio yet. I need you to keep proving my point even further. I mean, it's not like PAX and GDC and other. The majority of people don't agree. That's why they banned booth babes already. Lamau, this is great. I love it. Well, just because one person at PAX bullied the rest of everyone into removing booth babes is that doesn't prove you right. I mean, that is a false equivalency. Is that fair to say? I'm not sure. I'm not hip to all the jive, but I do know that it does not prove it. And it's funny calling people incels when you think about who's subscribing to somebody who paints their chest on Twitch. And you see just more and more of this antagonizing. You know, I said a lesser man will be point out a pretty big difference between that avatar and real life. That's not very body positive, but thankfully I'm way above that. This is the avatar, definitely not objectifying anything. And this is the pinned tweet, all right? So, of course, the hypocrisy ran wild. And if I want to give you a bit of lore, if you look back to what it was like when the grid girls, if you know Formula One racing, maybe you're, if you don't, you're at least aware of the Formula One grid girls, who some gross-looking feminists got outraged on their behalf, so Formula One removed them. However, the grid girls loved their jobs. They loved going to work. They loved getting paid to be a part of the sport. They loved everything about it, and they were all terminated because somebody like Zombie Unicorn got offended on their behalf. This article happened in early 2018. Calling the practice at odds with modern-day societal norms, Formula One Wednesday announced it would no longer employ grid girls, models who perform various promotional duties during races. Over the last year, nobody cares. The women, ridiculous, that women who say they are, quote, fighting for women's rights are saying that what others should and shouldn't do, stopping us from doing the job we love and are proud to do. PC gone mad. Now former grid girl Rebecca Cooper wrote on Twitter. Michelle Westby, meanwhile, wrote on Facebook that her experience as a grid girl helped pave the way for her entrance into a male-dominated world of stunt and drift competition driving. She also said a lot of women will lose their source of income. Thanks, feminists. This is exactly what I'm talking about. I'm talking about people getting offended on other people's behalves and now costing these women jobs. I don't know how many grid girls there were, but probably hundreds. I wasn't going to get involved in this whole band of grid girls debate, as I felt all the girls were handling it great. But recently seen some comments which really have my blood boiling, like, they have no purpose, intelligence, or even knowledge of cars, racing, and about time they got a proper job. First of all, the majority of girls working on the grid have a very strong interest in racing, like myself, and got involved in pit duties where possible. Right? Okay, so it's upsetting, and I'm rather disgusted that Formula One have given into the minority to be politically correct, a former grid girl named Charlotte Gash said. Gash. I'm one of the lucky ones that I don't rely on this as a main source of income, but there are girls out there that do. I know the grid girls are there to look pretty when they're out on the grid, but my role was interacting with the crowd, and we were there as an advertisement for the sponsors. We love doing it, and we didn't want it taken away from us. This is exactly what Zombie Unicorn is doing to Booth Babes. And to be very clear, the quote-unquote Booth Babes that she had a problem with twerking and whatever else, they were dancers, professional dancers that were dancing on an energy drink thing. Okay, fine. You don't like it. I think you're in the ultra minority. You're willing to take these jobs away and then stand out there on Twitter and talk about how you're not doing that. You're absolutely doing that. You're stirring up the vocal minority who will now go to E3 and say, well, look, this just can't happen. We can't have beautiful women. We can't have women who are better looking than me out here earning more money than me as I walk the floor and try to remain relevant. And you have, you know, here's the original tweet that I think may have started it. She tweeted the video. I replied, girl, you literally paint your boobs for tips on Twitch. 2,600 likes. That's probably the most I ever had. And, you know, it's just like everybody agrees. You know, you have this kind of stuff going on Twitch, right? This person is the person that said, I'm an artist. It's different when I do it. It's about the companies taking advantage of these people. The girls that are working, that are dancing, by the way, are not there beyond against their will. You know, they're there to earn a living, to pay for their families, to pay for their rent, their heat, their electricity, their high-speed internet, their photo shoots, their headshots, all that kind of thing. That's what they're there to do. They are not being abused by the company. This was an enormously bad take. And you have one of them here, when Angry Joe, oh my God, based on Red Pill, Joe gets in. She replies to him, belong on the gaming convention floor. The fact still stands that they were scantily clad. They were basically twerking every time I saw them and unnecessarily and irrelevant. This is coming from somebody who was wearing see-through pants, by the way, at the time, and irrelevant to sell a bad energy drink. Had this been different venue or con, it might be acceptable. But the point I'm making is that it doesn't belong on the gaming convention floor because the history of poor treatment of women in the community. Yeah, only Zombie Unicorn can waddle around out there, all right? Because you can't have fit, beautiful women out there to get people's attention. Yeah, I'm sure a lot of people complain. And you actually saw Joe come in and, whoo, so proud of you, Joe. Replying to the video, Zombie, I hope you could take this as a bit of friendly criticism. This was a bad take. Those girls are clearly dancers performing, not booth babes. If you have an issue with revealing shorts on the dancers, that's fine. But it's hard to take you serious when this next pic on your own Twitter feed. Roasted. And then she just gets triggered. saying, I hope you take a bit of friendly criticism. Using the attire I wear in my personal time to defend a company only hiring and representing women purely as spicy objects is sexist. Clearly, I'm a body positive person. This isn't about models consenting to work. Yes, it is. I mean, I don't know what razor's edge you're dancing on here, but this is an enormously bad take. And she kept going. This is about companies only hiring women as objects, essentially selling them as the product and not the product itself. Really? So do you have a problem with Twitch? Zombie Unicorn, do you have a problem with Twitch and all the girls on there shaking it? I don't think you've publicly said that. You know what you should probably do, Zombie Unicorn, is boycott Twitch because they're also profiting from women as objects, don't you think? And you see, Joe, LOL, you gave me 12 seconds to reply. Gee, clearly you are heated. Just relax and look at multiple points of view. The issue here is you're convinced, I think he meant, that the second part is true and a clear example. It's not. It's your opinion of the dancers hired to perform. And then that was it. It was over for her. Joe came in and dealt the final blow. And of course, the internet responded in kind. I mean, I think that what we're going to see here, let me predict how this goes. This is obviously a massive amount of hypocrisy that will hit the blogosphere probably Monday. People will be defending this woman. She will probably gain more Twitch subscribers. But the overwhelming majority of people will now see this woman for what she is. This okay for me, rules for thee, but not for me. What she does is art. What they do is exploitation, even if they're willing to, you know, be trained dancers out there in a, you know, in a uniform and learn to, you know, sell the product. This is a problem for everyone else, but not Zombie Unicorn, of course, you know, the bully hunter. And it's just the most perfect example of the hypocrisy that we deal with in the gaming industry. I have no problem with booth babes, men or women. I think if you have good-looking male or female models and they help you sell your product, what's wrong with that? These people are getting paid for their time. I mean, do you have a problem with dancers? Do you have a problem with actors? Do you have a problem with models? How about Tyra Banks, who started as an F1 grid girl? Now she's like a super rich, powerful model mogul, business mogul. Do you have a problem with that? I mean, this is a hilariously bad take. And for somebody with 100,000 followers who's getting literally no support on Twitter, it's over for Zombie Unicorn. Please go find a regular job and fade off into obscurity. But what I think will happen is the feminists will use her to prop up an argument. And of course, it will become about toxic male masculinity and all sorts of bullying and stuff like that. But we know, we see what's up. We see her for the hypocrite she is. Have a great weekend, everybody. Zombie Unicorn is canceled.